Good morning to you all. Today I wish to discuss 50 important multiple choice questions based on the conduct rule of central government employees in India, which are primarily governed by the Central Civil Service Conduct Rule 1964. The first question is, the Central Civil Service Conduct Rule was established in which year? The options are A, 1960, B, 1962, C, 1964, D, 1966. The correct answer is C, 1964. Question number 2. The conduct rule applied to which category of the employees? Options are A, Group A, B, Group B, C, Group C, D, all the above. The correct answer is D, all the above. Question number 3. Under CCS conduct rule, which is not considered misconduct? Option A, acceptance of gift. Option B, unauthorized communication of information. Option C, attendance at the political rallies. Option D, obtaining prior permission for leaving headquarters. The correct answer is D, obtaining prior permission for leaving headquarters. The rest three are considered as misconduct. Only the D is not conduct as misconduct, which is obtaining prior permission for leaving headquarters. Question number 4. As per the rule, a government employee must not be involved in, options are A, political parties, B, financial investment, C, social activities, D, none of the above. The correct answer is A, political parties. So if an employee participate in political parties, then it is a misconduct under the conduct rule. The financial investment, social activities are not the activities in which a government servant must not participate. They may participate in financial investment, they may also participate in social activities, but they may not participate in political parties. Hence the correct answer is A. Question number 5. Which of the following is restricted under the conduct rule regarding gift for government employees? Option A, cash gift. Option B, token gift for on festive occasions. C, gift from family members. D, all the above. The correct answer is A, cash gift. Cash gift is restricted under the conduct rule. Token gift may be taken on festive occasion. Gift from the family members may be taken, but cash gift is prohibited, that is restricted under the conduct rule. Question number 6. As per the rule, an employee should not accept gift costing more than dash from a person other than the relatives or personal friends. Option A, 2000 rupees. Option B, rupees 5000. Option C, rupees 10,000. Option D, rupees 25,000. The correct answer is B, rupees 5000. If an employee should not accept a gift of costing more than 5000 from the person other than the relative or personal friends. Question number 7. An employee is required to maintain which of the following with respect to government property? Option A, casual attitude. Option B, good faith. Option C, integrity and devotion. Option D, none of the above. The correct answer is C, integrity and devotion. Next is question number 8. Can a government servant join any political party? Option A, yes, with permission. Option B, yes, without permission. Option C, no. Option D, only after retirement. The correct answer is C, no. No government servant may join the political party. Question number 9. The conduct rule prohibits government employees from engaging in dash without permission. Option A, private trade or employment. Option B, social service activities. Option C, volunteering for NGO. Option D, academic pursuits. The correct answer is A, private trade or employment. So conduct rule prohibits the government employee to participate in private trade or employment. However, they may participate in social service activities. They may participate in volunteering for NGOs. They may participate in academic pursuits, but they may not participate in private trade or employment without permission. Next, question number 10. Government servant must maintain dues with public. Option A, strict discipline. Option B, cordial and cooperative relations. Option C, superior attitude. Option D, none of the above. The correct answer is B, cordial and cooperative relations is the correct answer. The government servant must maintain cordial and cooperative relation with the public. Question number 11. Can a government servant contest election to a local body? Option A, yes, without any permission. Option B, yes, with the prior permission. Option C, under any circumstances. No, under any circumstances. And option D, yes, after resignation from the job. The correct answer is yes, but with prior permission. If a government employee gets prior permission to participate in the local body election, then he may or she may participate. Question number 12. The conduct rule require employee to provide information about movable or immovable property if the value exceeds option A, 1 month basic pay. Option B, 2 month basic pay. Option C, ₹25,000. Option D, ₹50,000. The correct answer is A, that is 1 month basic pay. If the value exceeds 1 month basic pay, then the employee must take prior permission to purchase a movable or immovable property. Question number 13. As per rule 11, no government employee shall criticize the policies of government in dues. Option A, public speech. Option B, articles or newspaper. Option C, radio or television broadcast. Option D, all the above. The correct answer is D, all the above. A government employee may not criticize the policies of government in public speech, in articles or newspaper, in radio or television broadcast. Question number 14. Government employee must refrain from participating in which of the following activities? Option A, election duty. Option B, public service campaign. Option C, strike. Option D, voluntary social service. The correct answer is C, strike. So government employee must refrain from participating in the strike. Question number 15. Government employees should follow the principle of dues in the public dealing. Option A, favoritism. Option B, neutrality. Option C, biased. Option D, nepotism. So correct answer is B, neutrality. Government employees should follow the principle of neutrality in the public dealing. Question number 16. Employees are required to refrain from consuming intoxicating drinks or drugs during which of the following? Option A, office hours. Option B, public places. Option D, official functions. Option D, all the above. The correct answer is D, all the above. Intoxicating drinks or drugs is not allowed in office hours or public places or in official function. These are prohibited in all these. Hence, the correct answer is D, all the above. Question number 17. Which rule deals with the taking part in politics and election under the CCS Conduct Rule 1964? Option A, Rule 3. Option B, Rule 4. Option C, Rule 5. Option D, Rule 6. The correct answer is Rule 5. So Rule 5 prohibits the government employees in taking part in politics and election. Question number 18. Every government servant should declare his or her asset at the interval of every 10 years. option A 1, option B 2, option 3 C, option C 3, option D 5. The correct answer is 1. After every 1 year, every government servant should declare his or her asset. Question number 19. Can a government employee use their position for private gain? Option A, yes. Option B, no. Option C, only in emergencies. Option D, with permission. The correct answer is no. No government employee use their position for private gain. Question number 20. Which of the following activities is allowed for a government servant without permission? Option A, freelance writing. Option B, investing in stock market. Option C, participation in sports activity. Option D, managing family business. The correct answer is C, participation in sports activity. Except participation in sports activity, all other things are banned for government servant to take part without permission. Question number 21. Rule 3 of the CCSconduct rule takes about option A, financial dealing. Option B, devotion to duty and integrity. Option C, consumption of intoxicants. Option D, political activities. The correct answer is option B, devotion to duty and integrity. Next, question number 22. In which case can a government servant accept gift from foreign dignitaries? Option A, with the government permission. Option B, without any permission. Option C, never. Option D, after seeking approval from the superior officer. The correct answer is option A, with the government permission. A government servant may accept gift from the foreign dignitaries. Question number 23. As per rule 9, which of the following is forbidden for a government servant? Option A, getting married. Option B, marriage with a foreign national. Option C, leaving India without permission. Option D, taking election loan, educational loan. Correct answer is B, marriage with a foreign national. Question number 24. A government servant is not allowed to engage in speculative activities such as option A, lottery. Option B, betting on the horse race. Option C, stock market. Option D, both A and B. A government servant is not allowed to engage in speculative activities in lottery as well as betting on the horse race. Hence, the correct option is A. Both A and B. Question number 25. Which of the following conduct is expected from a government servant towards his or her superiors and colleagues? Option A, respect. Option B, obedience. Option C, cooperation. Option D, all the above. All the three above activities are expected from a government servant towards his or her superior and colleagues. That is, all the above is the correct answer. Hence, a government servant is expected to have the respect of the seniors, to have the obedience of seniors, to have the cooperation of the senior colleagues and superiors. Question number 26. Can a government employee participate in a radio talk or television broadcast? Option A, yes, with permission. Without permission. B, yes, with permission. C, no, under any circumstances. Option D, only after retirement. The correct answer is B, yes, with permission. Question number 27. The rule 21 of CCS conduct rule deals with option A, investment and borrowing. Option B, acceptance of dowry. Option C, participation in election. Option D, criticism of government. The correct answer is B, acceptance of dowry. Is banned under rule 21 of CCS conduct rule 1964. Question number 28. Under the conduct rule, any financial dealing between an employee and his or her subordinate are option A, allowed. option B, encouraged, option C, discouraged, option D, prohibited. So correct answer is D, prohibited. So any financial dealing between an employee and his or her subordinate is totally prohibited. Question number 29. No government employee should indulge in debts to evade income tax. Option A, bribery. Option B, under reporting to income. Option C, gifting large sums. Option D, all the above. The correct answer is B, under reporting income. So no government employee should indulge in under reporting income to evade income tax. Question number 30. What is the maximum value of a gift from relatives that a government servant can accept on an occasion without reporting? Option A, rupees 2000. Option B, rupees 5000. Option C, rupees 10,000. Option D, rupees 25,000. The correct answer is C, 10,000. Question number 31. Under which rule is a government employee restricted from criticizing the government in public? Option A, rule 7. Option B, rule 9. Option C, rule 10. Option D, rule 11. The correct answer is D, rule 11. Question number 32. Can a government servant acquire movable property without prior approval of competent authority? Option A, yes, if it is below a specific value. Option B, no. Option C, only in emergencies. Option D, only for vehicles. The correct answer is A, yes. If it is below a specific value, then a government employee may acquire immovable property without prior approval. Question number 33. A government servant is permitted to attend social events provided they do not option A, violate laws. Option B, criticize government policies. Option C, impair the image of service. Option D, all the above. The correct answer is all the above. So a government servant is permitted to attend the social events provided they do not violate law, provided they do not criticize government policies, provided they impair the image of service. Question number 34. The prohibition on participating in the strike extends to options A, hunger strike, option B, sit-in strike, option C, picketing, option D, all the above. The correct answer is all the above, because all are the part of strike. Question number 35. Rule 4 of the CCS conduct rule primarily deals with the option A, private trade, option B, integrity and honesty, option C, gift taking, option D, loyalty to government. The correct answer is B, integrity and honesty is under rule 4. Of the CCS conduct rule deals with integrity and honesty. Question number 36. Can a government employee invest in share and stocks? Option A, yes. Option B, no. Option C, yes, but without speculative behavior. Option D, yes, with prior permission. The correct answer is C, yes, but without speculative behavior. Question number 37. Can a government employee accept an award from foreign organization without permission? Option A, yes. Option B, no. Option C, yes, after retirement. Option D, yes, if invited directly. The correct answer is no. Question number 38. A government employee participation in religious activities should be option A, encouraged, option B, in private and non-political, option C, mandatory, option D, prohibited. The correct answer is option B, in private and non-political. Question number 39. Government servant must seek permission before taking up option A, non-remunerative work, option B, short-term studies, option C, paid work outside the service, option D, none of the above. The correct answer is C, paid work outside the service. Government servant must seek permission for the paid work outside the service. Question number 40. Which of the following constitute misconduct under CCS conduct rule? Option A, criticizing government decision. Option B, investing in public bonds. Option C, participating in official workshop. Option D, attending official meeting. So correct answer is A, criticizing government decisions. Question number 41. Rule 19 of CCS conduct rule pertains to option A, employment of a family member in private business. Option B, dowry prohibition. Option C, investment restrictions. Option D, connection with press or radio. So correct answer is D, connection with press or radio. Rule 19 of CCS conduct rule pertains to connection with press or radio. Question number 42. A government servant is required to report acquisition of property above a value of dash. Option A, rupees 10,000. Option B, rupees 25,000. Option C, 2 months salary. Option D, 3 months salary. The correct answer is C, 2 months salary. Question number 43. Government employee must avoid habitual indebtedness and refrain from option A, borrowing from the subordinates. Option B, excessive lifestyles. Option C, financial mismanagement. Option D, all the above. The correct answer is D, all the above. So government employee must avoid habitual indebtedness and refrain from the borrowing from subordinates, excessive lifestyle, and financial mismanagement. All these three are they must avoid. Question number 44. Can government servant receive foreign hospitality without permission? Option A, yes. Option B, no. Option C, yes, under certain circumstances. Option D, only for official duty. The correct answer is D, only for official duty. A government servant may receive foreign hospitality without permission. Question number 45. Government employee must act dash in all matters related to public resources. Option A, nepotism. Option B, fairness and impartiality. Option C, biased. Option D, authority. The correct answer is B, fairness and impartiality. Question number 46. Under Rule 3, government servant should strive to maintain option A, political alliance. Option B, devotion to duty and integrity. Option C, financial independence. Option D, social relationship. Correct answer is B, devotion to duty and integrity. Question number 47. Can a government employee raise funds for a cause? Option A, yes, without permission. Option B, yes, with permission. Option C, no. Option D, yes, but not during working hours. The correct answer is yes, with but with permission. That is, a government employee may raise a fund for a cause with the permission of government. 48. The government servant conduct rules prohibits receiving dowry under which rule? Option A, rule 20. Option B, rule 21. Option C, rule 22. Option D, rule 23. The correct answer is rule 21. Question number 49. A government servant must maintain confidentiality concerning option A, publicly availing information. Option B, internal communication. Option C, official secrets. Option D, information of little consequences. The correct answer is C, official secrets. Question number 50. Is it mandatory for a government employee to report an act of corruption that comes to his or her notice? Option A, yes. Option B, no. Option C, only when asked. Option D, depends on the situation. The correct answer is yes. It is mandatory for a government employee to report an act of corruption that comes to his or her notice immediately. These MCQ provides a comprehensive review of CCS conduct rule essential for exams or knowledge of central government conduct regulation in India. In case of any doubt, please go through the DOPT rules. Please go through the Conduct Rule 1964. If you have any doubt, please verify from the DOPT Rules 1964. I have discussed 50 important questions for AC, principal, or teachers exams of KVS, NVS, or Delhi Board or others. Please go through all these questions, and if you like these questions, please forward these questions to others also, so that most of the teachers may be benefited who are taking part or who are going to take part in the competitive exams. If you like this video, please like my video and please subscribe my channel. Please send these videos to more and more teachers and employees those are preparing for the exams. Thank you.